نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد، الذي لم يتخذ صاحبة ولا ولدا، ولم يجعل في الدين حرجا، أول بلا ابتداء، آخر بلا انتهاء، لا يفنى ولا يبيد، ولا يكون إلا ما يريد، حي قيوم لا يموت، والجن والإنس يموتون، بيده الخير إنه على كل شيء قدير. ونشهد أن نبينا وحبيبنا وإمامنا وقدوتنا ومعلمنا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى آتاه اليقين، فترك الأمة على المحجة البيضاء ليلها ونهارها سواء. أما بعد، أوصيكم ونفسي أولا بتقوى الله، اتقوا الله سبحانه وتعالى في السر والعلن، وذروا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن. إن الله سبحانه وتعالى قد أمرنا بحصول التقوى مرارا، يقول الله عز وجل: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال جل وعلا في بداية سورة النساء: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. وقال جل وعلا: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. Brothers and sisters, the month of Rabi'ul Awwal just went past recently. In the month of Rabi'ul Awwal, you may have studied regarding Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You may have studied his seerah. You may have studied the Holy Quran in order to discover regarding Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and my sisters, in the entire Quran, you'll find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You'll find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressing Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You'll find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly commanding Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, every page of the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying something to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or about Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu ta'ala anha, the beloved wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the respected mother of the believers, she was asked by the Sahaba and Tabi'un that what was the characteristics of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu ta'ala anha responded very briefly, kana khuluquhu al-Qur'an. That if you want to see Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's character, if you want to see Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the real life, if you want to see the noble characteristics of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recite the Holy Quran. When you recite the Holy Quran, you'll find many things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spoken about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah ta'ala talks about the rank of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the beauty of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam residing in Makkah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam residing in Al-Madinatul Munawwar. All of these things are found in the Holy Quran. But my brothers and my sisters, you must have come across an ayat in the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, despite talking about all the other elements of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his characteristics in the Holy Quran, but this only one little ayat of the Holy Quran touches me the most. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is explained and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is discovered to the ummah, to the entire humanity by his creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by saying, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. That Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have not sent you, but as a mercy for the entire universe. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he himself is a mercy. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his deen is a mercy. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's message is a mercy. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah ta'ala sent him the Holy Quran. The Quran is a mercy. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's sharia is a mercy. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's sunnah is a mercy. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's characteristic is a mercy. If the mercy was to be seen in the shape of something or somebody, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ That Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have not sent you but as a mercy for the entire universe. On this ayat, my brothers and my elders, my sisters, my youngsters, we can write and talk about hours and hours, days and nights regarding وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ But from the ocean of mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I just like to touch upon one thing. And that one thing is, my brothers, nowadays is very much needed. And that is sacrifice for others. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, despite being the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, despite having the most loftiest rank among the entire creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, despite being the Habib wa Rabbil Alameen, the most beloved of the Lord of the universe, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being the Sayyidu waladi Adam yawm al-qiyamati wala fakhra. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being the leader of the entire children of Adam. And Allah ta'ala will show that to the entire universe on the day of judgment. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, I am not boasting with it. It's a mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jannah is haram on anybody. Jannah is haram and forbidden for anyone to step in besides Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Until Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam opens the door of Jannah and steps into Jannah, no one is allowed to enter the Jannah. That is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On the day of judgment, all the prophets alayhi salatu wa sallam, from Adam alayhi salam to Isa alayhi salam, everyone will be saying, Ya Rabbi sallim, Ya Rabbi sallim, Ya Rabbi sallim. My Lord, please protect. My Lord, please protect. My Lord, please protect. At that time, only one person will rise and go under the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says himself, فَأَخِرُّ لِرَبِّي سَاجِدًا وَشَاكِرًا I shall prostrate to my Lord under the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, under the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says, those praise regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I don't know them now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put them in my mind in the day of judgment while I am prostrating for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala under the arsh of Allah ta'ala. And I'll praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for so long, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows for how long. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have the sympathy and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Muhammad, irfa rasak, sal tu'ta, washfa' tushaffa. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be called by Allah. Muhammad, raise your hand. Ask, you will be granted. Intercede, your intercession will be accepted. Allahu Akbar. This is the rank our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. We recite, Asa an yab'athaka maqaman mahmuda. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah ta'ala has granted you the maqam mahmud on the day of judgment. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has all of that. But my brothers and my sisters, one thing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had inside him, and that is preference to the others. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is described, his companions are described by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described the companions as well, that sahaba were such, the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were such, they adopted from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that I may suffer, I may take the blame, I may take the pain, etc., etc. But because of me, other people will not take any pain. Because of me, other people will live in prosperity. Other people will live in peace and tranquility. وَيُوْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains the spirit of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's mercy is that وَيُوْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his teaching and his companions were such that they will give preference to the others even though if they are suffering, if they are hungry. Sayyidah Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha gives the best example of that in the hadith in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha narrates that a lady came. And the lady said to Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha that give us something. She was a beggar lady, she wanted something out of Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha. My brothers and my sisters, Allahu Akbar, we live a luxurious life nowadays. But just take the hadith of Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha, this hadith which I'm going to quote, another hadith as well before I quote the other one. Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha said, in the house of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, several moons used to be sighted, new crescent used to be sighted, several months used to go past, but in the house of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is nothing to consume besides aswadan, two black things, water and dates. And this occasion, Sahih Bukhari, Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha says, that she comes and she says, Ummul Mumineen, give us something to eat. She says, in that day we had only one date in our house. Me needs to need to eat. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam need to eat as well. But we had only one date. Look at the prophecy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at the prophecy of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his mission, how Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam conveyed that to his wives, his children, his companions, his followers and his ummah. Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha doesn't think for a while that I have only one date. If I give it to that lady, then I will be hungry for the rest of the day. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will also remain hungry for the rest of the day. But the spirit was there. وَيُسِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا. That they give preference to others, even though if they are suffering, if they are hungry. Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, without any contemplation, without any thought, Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha gives that day to that lady. Now my brothers and my sisters, look what happens next. That lady takes that date. She doesn't eat it either. Because she has two young daughters with her. That lady takes the date from Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, breaks into two pieces, and gives one piece to one daughter, and the other piece to the other daughter. And the mother remains hungry. Again, the prophecy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to see here, وَيُسِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا. That they give preference to others, even though if they are suffering, if they are hungry. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes in. Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha reports to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that ya Rasulullah, this is what happened. A lady came and she was asking for some food. We never had anything besides only one date. And ya Rasulullah, I have given that date in the path of Allah ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha, ittaqin nar walau bishiqi tamarati. That Aisha, protect yourself from the fire of hell, even giving a piece of date in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is charity. My brothers and my elders, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my sisters, my youngsters, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always showed us to care for the ummah, to love for the ummah, to cry for the ummah, to give preference to the ummah over me. Allahu Akbar, we have read in the books of Seerah, at the time of the Battle of Trench, Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhi ajma'in, they were digging the trench around Al-Madinatul Munawwara. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam participated. It's not like that, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the leader, is the prophet. He remains in a comfortable house and he just commands from there and he watches to the satellite dishes that the workers are working. No. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam personally joins the team and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also did it. Sahaba come and Sahaba say, ya Rasulullah, for so many days we've been working tirelessly, ya Rasulullah. Now there is not enough food. And in order to remain standing, ya Rasulullah, and strong, we have tied stones onto our stomachs. Sahaba says that Rafa'na an butunina an hajarin an hajarin, that we have shown Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we have tied one stone on our stomach in order to remain strong so we can carry on with the job. Subhanallah, ulama of Seerah have recorded Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lifted his shirt and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tied two stones on his stomach. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and my elders, from the month of Rabi'ul Awwal, or whenever the month of Rabi'ul Awwal comes, whenever we study and whenever we need to know regarding Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that spirit of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that message of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a mercy, and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's prophecy and his mission described by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيُوثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا, is mentioned in the Quran. Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, they had it. Ummahatul Mu'mineen, they had it. The family members of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they had it. The Aryan nation, they had it. Now this gradually, the whole of the mission has came to us. And we need to carry that mission from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that وَيُوثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا, give preference to others whenever I am in need. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the tawfiq and the ability to practice the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا, أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا, من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن نبينا وحبيبنا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد, إن الله سبحانه وتعالى قد أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه ثم ثنى بملائكة قدسه ثم ثلث بالمؤمنين من برية إنسه وجنه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد أما بعد Brothers and sisters, so as far as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is concerned, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the best role model for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Holy Quran, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِدْتُمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described by Allah ta'ala that came to your Prophet, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ from you, from best of you, عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِدْتُمْ Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's attachment with the ummah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's connection with the ummah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's care for the ummah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's crying out for this ummah. Allah says, Azizun alayhi ma anittum. That Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is extremely unbearable for him to observe the ummah is suffering. Azizun alayhi ma anittum. حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is extremely eager regarding the ummah, regarding the mu'minun. حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْهِ Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam extremely eager regarding the ummah in order to care for the ummah, sacrifice for the ummah. We have just recited Surah Al-Kahf. And every Friday we recite Surah Al-Kahf. Have you ever contemplated on this ayat? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ إِنْ لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسَفًا And Allah Ta'ala repeated this ayat in the Holy Quran. Allah Ta'ala talks about the care of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the ummah, for the humanity. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Allah Ta'ala says that فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ That it seems like O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for the care and love for the ummah, you are going to destroy yourself. Imam al-Muhalli rahimahullah in the tafsir of Jalalayn, he says فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ أي هَالِكٌ نَفْسَكَ That Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of your care, because of your love, because of your connection with your ummah, and cry for the ummah, it seems like you are going to destroy yourself. You are going to kill yourself. My brothers and my elders, my sisters, the ummah is suffering. Ustad, I don't have to mention where the ummah is suffering. The ummah is suffering globally. The ummah is suffering every day. The ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prepared, and which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cried and wept for. That ummah is crying out. That ummah is dying every day. We need to cry for the ummah. Care for the ummah. Make dua for the ummah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect this ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard this ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let the ummah prosper. Doesn't matter what the taghut does. That this ummah will prosper. This ummah will remain until the morning of the day of judgment. The ummah will never die. The ummah will never perish. The ummah will always remain standing strongly with the Quran and Sunnah. So therefore we need to be with them, we need to support them, and we need to remain steadfast on the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and on the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر المسلمين المظلومين المستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها اللهم أدم الأمن والإيمان والسلامة والقرار في جميع البلاد اللهم قص بها بلاد المسلمين يا رب العالمين اللهم أدم عليها أمنها وإيمانها وسلامتها واستقرارها وعزها وشرفها وسخاءها ورخاءها وعقيدتها وشامخها بفضلك ومنك وجودك وكرمك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم انصر إخواننا المسلمين في فلسطين وفي جميع أوطان المسلمين يا رب العالمين اللهم رد بيت المقدس إلى أيدي المسلمين سالمة عزيزة منيعة حريصة إلى يوم الدين عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون واذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وأجل وأتم وأهم وأعظم وأقوى وأكبر Please stand up and sit in your rows.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
Please send over the rows, occupy the punches first, turn up the mobile phones as well, please. Then shoulder to shoulder here on the line. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.